dos idiomas, pero primero inglés, porque es mi primer idioma. It's so great to see you all out here tonight, or today after a very long day of marching. Today was such an inspiring day to have thousands and thousands of people to come out in San Francisco to say no to what is happening to the people at the border. A false border, a border that shouldn't even be there, a border that cannot say no to humans when it says yes to every single corporation that goes to Mexico and Guatemala and Honduras and South to exploit and exploit without restrictions. Yet somehow they believe they can say no to the actually humans who do that work. Those humans are adults, but they're also children. And we have a child, we have many children at my school who have crossed the border, which in and of itself is such a hard thing to do. They come with so much they have to deal with just to sit in that classroom and learn. But our kids have also been in those detention centers. And they're right here in San Francisco. They're in our schools. And they've been taken. They've been placed in horrible conditions for weeks. They've been flown across the country and back again by themselves after being separated with the family members they came from. They don't speak English. And the ICE and the Border Patrol teach them the Pledge of Allegiance. That's what they teach them to these children who are being abused. They draw their blood, they give them vaccinations, and they horribly abuse them, and then sometimes they make it back to their families. And when they do, they come into our schools, and you can't even imagine what they face. What they face here in this country where you don't have rights, where you don't have a right even to speak your language sometimes. But you don't have a right to the basic things you need. You aren't provided with housing. And the education you're getting, we try hard. I'm not knocking the teachers, but it's not what it needs to be. Because there isn't a political will behind it giving us the funds we need to do what we want to do for these kids. They don't have a right to health care. They don't have a right to eat. That's the country we live in. That's the situation we're facing. And it can get us down. It can be hard. It can be hard to sit with that kid and hear that story and know that you have to teach him or her or them something they need to grow and to succeed and that you can't provide everything for them. So what do? We do what we did today. We get out, we get in the streets, we organize, we mobilize, we break that border down. We tell them that they're going to build a wall, we're going to take it down. We're going to walk down there, take it down, we're going to leave water. We don't care if you charge us with a felony for leaving water. We're going to take care of our people. Because we see the people of Mexico, Guatemala, of Latin America as our brothers and sisters. We don't care about the ruling class of this country, we care about them. So I stand here as a mother of two, as a parent in the public school system, and as a teacher. We have to close those camps. We have to take down that border, and we demand full rights for every single person in this country. Gracias a todos por estar aquí. Bien, yo soy bien orgullosa de ver todas las personas que han marchado hoy, que han ido a las calles para exigir los derechos plenos de todos los inmigrantes, que nosotros cerramos los centros de detención. Es crítico que nosotros hacemos ese movimiento, porque nosotros en las escuelas hemos visto lo que está pasando con nuestros niños. Nosotros hemos visto los niños que no han ido a los centros, pero ellos han tenido a cruzar la frontera y ha afectado a ellos. Ellos no pueden aprender en nuestras escuelas por lo que está pasando en sus vidas. Pero en las escuelas aquí, en San Francisco, tenemos niños. han estado en los centros de detención. Y es horrible lo que están diciendo a nosotros, lo que ha pasado a ellos, que ellos tienen que, después de han separado de sus familias, ahí, ten cuidado. Ellos dan ir de vuelta a Nueva York, a Houston y después a San Francisco, solitos. Ellos han hecho pruebas con su sangre y no han enseñado nada. Solo el Pledge of Allegiance en inglés. Nada. Y ellos están enfrentando la situación de este país en que, lo siento, he enseñado todo el día, y que no hay derecho a viviendas, a salud, a comer. No hay nada en este país que no puede luchar, si no puede luchar.
Espera un momentico.
Entonces estamos aquí con todos, como maestra, como mamá, estamos aquí en solidaridad con todos que están luchando para cerrar los centros de detención porque la frontera es falsa. Nosotros somos un pueblo unido, juntos, en frente.